It's good.
Okay. Take it away.
About a boy and a girl that fall into an alternate world where Poe's stories are coming to life.
Bethany Griffin, who wrote The Mask of the Red Death and The Dance of the Red Death, which are books based upon and inspired by Poe's stories, The Mask of the Red Death. And then there's this girl right here, Kaylee Cochran, whose books are not yet published, but will be soon, and has been inspired by Edgar Allan Poe nonetheless. These writers, while all in different genres, all pay homage to one great man. Edgar Allan Poe is a literary genius because he helped inspire an entire genre of writing. Now, most of you guys are thinking, okay, he wrote stories like The Tales of Heart and The Mask of the Red Death, which are pretty scary stories, but Poe actually helped inspire the detective story genre. This is not something that just any person can do. You have to be a genius in your field to be able to do something like this. According to the history of mystery.com, as well as several other books, Edgar Allan Poe is known as the father of detective fiction. He went on to write stories like The Murders of the Freehorn, The Purloined Letter, and The Mystery of Marie Broquet. Poe is even inspiring in his detective tales, as his character, C. Augustine Dupin, went on to inspire detective artists like Sherlock Holmes and many others. Edgar Allan Poe is a man of tragedy, but also a man of strength, because he managed to turn such a tragic life into one great success. Poe never truly gained the recognition he deserved while he was alive, and the least we can do is give him the recognition he deserves now that he's passed. Edgar Allan Poe has been passed over by a madman by many different people who never took the time to examine his true nature. Let's take a note and learn from the misconception of Poe that next time, before you pass someone off as what their reputation leads them to be, take a moment for yourself and look at them before you pass.
Most people don't. Yeah, we're good.